2016 Mustang GT, and it's a bit nasty. Doesn't put a smile on your face, that's your problem, not the car's, because this car is so much fun, has so much character. And just, let's do that again. Third gear, let's go to second. All right, second gear, 55 miles an hour. Ready? 7 grand, 80, 5, 90, 5, 100. Wow, I wasn't going 100. We're in Mexico. That was awesome. So the Coyote this year it's a little bit stronger, a little better built. You're getting about 435 horsepower to the crank out of it, and then around 400 pounds of torque. And look, I know there's faster cars out there, I get that. But man, for under 30 grand for a base model car like this one, I got this car for under 30 grand. You can't ask for much better. This car's really good. So, let me elaborate a little bit on the performance of this car. 0-60 happens in about 4.5 seconds. That's DV9 territory in a Mustang. Now, I know the Mustang stigma of it's a Mustang, it's meant to go in a straight line, it's not meant to corner at all and do anything that a real performance car can do. But, that's this car's party piece. It can go around corners now. It's so poised and balanced now. It doesn't have that nervous feeling that the last car had, that every time you were going to go over a pebble, you thought you were going to slide around backwards and die. You know, this car is definitely bigger than the last car, and when you walk up to it, you can really tell that this car is a lot bigger. But when you get in it, the car does a really good job of shrinking around you, and it doesn't feel as big. I mean, yes, you do have a hood that stretches out for about 6 miles, but that's kind of cool because it means you have a big engine under there, and it makes you very happy. You know, speaking of the interior of this car and being inside the car, my last car was a 2012 Mustang, the previous generation. And when I first got it, I really thought the interior was top-notch. This is a big step for Ford in the interior. But then when I got in this car, everything changed. This is the one thing that doesn't feel like a Mustang. It's everything's nice. There's no just, I mean, you have some plastic, but it's nice. And then, you know, everything that you touch is soft. You know, your armpit, the armrest are super soft on either side. The steering wheel is nice and leather wrapped like it should be. And, you know, the one thing about the interior of this car is it's a lot smaller steering wheel. I mean, I always liked the big steering wheel in the old car. It was kind of fun, manly, and beefy. But, you know, this car is a lot smaller steering wheel, which in the real world feels better in your hands. So, I'm sure that there are better cars out there in this world. But because I haven't driven them yet, especially for the price. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this little video, and I will